They're gonna take the medals, they're gonna come over here, put it over your head, shake your hand. So then you guys will all have your medals on your chest. They're gonna go back over, at which point Shox is going to say, once again, let's hear it for the 2015 MSI champions, SK Telecom, T1, and confetti's gonna go off then even more. It's gonna be going around, crowd's gonna be going crazy, and we're just gonna stay on that moment for a minute while, you know, everyone is acknowledging their victory.
Welcome back to our continuing coverage of the 2015 Mid-Season Invitational. And gentlemen, it all comes down to this Game 5. Who would have thought it? Faker versus Pawn in the mid lane. I mean, this is just story for the ages here, Mid-Season Invitational. Who's the best in the world?
근데 여기서 하나 중요한 게 상대가 만약에 근데 막밴이나 뭐 보고 가야 되는 거잖아. 나르르 됐어.
그러니까 꼭 뭐 픽도 좋은 픽도 있고 막 하지만 그동안 해왔던 거 뭐 그동안 이제 또 승률이 뭐 잘 나왔었던 거 오히려 막상 하고 여운이 없는 게 전 더 좋다고 생각하기 때문에 근데 그냥 후회 없게만 하라고 했어요 이미.
With LeBlanc on the competitive stage, 12-0.
페이커 선수가 르블랑을 플레이할 때는 마치 축구에 비유하자면 메시의 돌파 같은 느낌이 들 때가 있어요. 환상적인 슈팅을 통해서 골을 만들어내는 모습. 그게 바로 페이커의 르블랑과.
Season 3, SKT was miles ahead of everybody else. Faker was the utmost, you know, the best player in League of Legends ever so far.
A little too tanky for the damage they're bringing. There's the mirror image from Faker.
Ooh, he's gonna start
dancing around.
Faker, especially at his prime, just a tier ahead of everybody else.
There for the 50-50. Baron going very low at 1500. It is going to go over to clear.
There goes Faker.
They take down Faker immediately. EDG could have eyes on the base.
That's one of the pitfalls. Once you reach the top, you just assume you're always gonna stay there.
Season Invitational, here's the last engage. EDG doesn't even see the turrets. Eyes on SKT. SK Telecom T1 are wiped. The Nexus turrets are going down. LPL's Edward Gaming are the 2015 Mid-Season Invitational Champions.
I'm going to win easily. 있을 것 같다는 생각을 했었는데 그 다음에 좀 그냥 간단히 말해서 선수들이 다 집중력이 떨어져서 못했던 것 같아요 잘
다른 픽을 했었다가 졌어요 근데 이 픽을 했었으면 이겼을 텐데 이런 마음이 생기는 게 저는 가장 좀 무섭다고 생각하거든요 근데 그때 당시에도 좀 그렇게 좋은 픽이 아닌 건 알았어요 르블랑이라는 게
다섯 번째 게임에서 EDG가 르블랑 밴을 하지 않는 것을 보고 저는 EDG가 함정을 팠구나라는 생각이 들었습니다. 르블랑이 픽된 순간 EDG 선수들은 나이스라는 환호를 외쳤습니다. 그리고 실제로 모르가나를 선택을 해서 르블랑이 무력할 수밖에 없는 상황을 만들었고
3분 동안 뭐 제대로 쉬지도 못해서
이런 시작부터
무튼 끝났잖아 쉬러 가자
오히려 이번에 져가지고 좀 더 본인들 부족한 거 좀 더 느껴가지고 물론 형도 똑같고 선수들도 느꼈으면 좋겠어 항상 형이 하는 멘트인데 조금씩 배우려고 하는 사람이 잘해 배우려고
왜냐면 졌는데 아무리 말해봤자 핑계로 들리기 때문에 원래 저 진판은 이야기하지 않고 항상 네, 지면은 이야기하지 않습니다 근데 MSI는 입고 싶어요 아 너무 힘들었어요 정말
Thank you.
to practice we can.
Yeah, I was like, I figured you guys probably figured out.
Bjergsen's the best player in NA by far. A lot of video gamers in 10 years will be forgotten. No one will say their names ever again. He definitely has a chance at being an immortal figure in the esports industry. The biggest thing that Bjergsen has to watch out for probably is his own ego. I spend the most time working with Bjergsen because he's argumentative, he has his own opinion and how he wants to do things. He's immature, he's cocky. In some ways, Bjergsen is the leader of the team, but it's a lot far away from what we think he can be and what he wanted to be.
I said, do you need me? And then Lospo said, no, we can get tower without you. And then after that, I went to push on mid, so I couldn't port. And then by the time I could port again, it was too late. We were already, like, at this point, it's too late to port. We'll lose anyway.
Right there, you know, Ezreal ran down, and I think you should have just ran down as well.
Well, I asked them, and they said they didn't need me, so I'm not going to run down.
That's the problem with our shot calling overall, is that you're always asking, and they're not sure, so you just...
I can't make the decision for them there. I don't think so. But I don't think that should be on me. That's not my accountability.
Whose accountability is it, then?
Them, because they're bottom. They should be calling for me if they need me.
Like, every single time, it's a 5v5 situation. You're kind of just saying, well, it's their fault because four of them are there. Then basically what you're doing is you're not even shot calling. You're just basically asking people questions. Like, yeah. Should we fight or not?
Like, I never wanted to be the shot caller.
But you are. Me. That's an overall shot call. That's a shot caller's point. They get all the information they need and they make a final decision. My problem there is no one made a call. People should be actively feeding you information and then you should make a final call.
As the mid laner of Team Solo Mid, usually the mid laner is the one who kind of controls everything. Bjergsen was 17 when he joined. Over time, his role became the captain.
Bjergsen's persona back then, childish, immature, talented.
At his core, he's still a fairly shy, fairly just nerdy video game guy. And he got shot up into this limelight.
Bjergsen filled in for Reginald, who was basically a god at mid lane. He was the boss, your coworker, your friend, all at the same time.
It's probably the only thing that's ever meant anything to me in life. Like, I've never worked so hard on one thing before.
Yes, Reginald was rumored to retire maybe a couple of times before, but nobody really expected it to actually happen.
I'm Bjergsen. How are you guys in your mid lane?
Who the fuck are you?
No change has been talked about more than TSM's signing of a former NIP star Bjergsen to take over the mid lane from Reginald.
It was a bit of a risky move because it was hit or miss. If it missed, you just failed in the eyes of many, many fans, and TSM is the biggest name within Western esports when it comes to League of Legends.
Everywhere we go, it seems like we're the fan favorites, but they don't see us as the favorites to win, most likely. I think they see us as the underdog.
I think a lot of people will say they don't enjoy the pressure on our team, but it's what drives us. Everyone wants to see TSM win. Everyone wants to see TSM lose.
I think this season we've had a lot of ups and downs. I feel like we've had a lot of trouble really ending games, and even the games that we're winning, they go really long, past like 40, 45 minutes, and I don't feel like it's something that should happen. With how we're playing right now, I'll probably give like a 6. I see a lot more potential in what we could do. We are not even playing at the best of our level yet, so probably a 6 is not doing too great.
I think Bjergsen puts a massive amount of pressure on himself. Bjergsen with TSM got absolutely obliterated at the mid-season Invitational.
Hate we get when we lose is incredible, and like, we really do invest a lot more to the team than any other team, so it's quite embarrassing when we don't perform. Sometimes it's really, really draining.
After losses and after difficult games, he's borderline mortified.
There's no way we were. There was no way we were prioritizing ganks on Sion lane, then snowballing Sion lane with bottom playing passive.
There were definitely times where we prioritized gank on Hecarim. There were definitely times we prioritized gank on Maokai.
Yeah, one gank on Maokai, no further snowball. After that, Dara said that himself.
I took losing very, very hard. I would kind of sink into this hole of depression. What could I have done? What could I have done? What could I have done to win this game or do anything different. Maybe I do suck. Maybe all of these bad things they're saying about me are true.
Hi, man.
So, I'm in a great mood, by the way. I had an awesome weekend.
Good.
Of losing. Twice.
Bjergsen is not expected to just go even. Bjergsen is expected to transcend that. He has to win every time. And if Bjergsen doesn't win by 10 or 20 CS in his lane, that means Bjergsen lost.
Being on TSM comes with a lot of benefits, but it also comes with a lot of responsibilities.
That's your accountability from now on, is to basically make the decision of, should I push mid or should I go down there?
Okay.
That's your accountability from now on.
I made the decision this game.
Okay, so next time, you should be aware and just be decisive and say, I'm going to go or not go at all, versus asking if you should go or not, because you can judge the situation yourself. And you're the mid laner. You are, for the better of the team, it makes more sense for you to take on that accountability.
Even if you don't know what to do here, you need to sound confident and you need to make a call that your team will follow, whether it's right or wrong, and that's something I need to get used to.
Bjergsen has the most popular stream in North America because he's the most hyped player, he's the most watched player. It sort of goes in a circle where he has the most popular stream, so people talk about him more, people watch him more, he's the best player, so people watch him more. Because people watch him more, people talk about him more, so they want to watch him more again. And being on TSM helps.
Well, there isn't really whether I want or not want to be a shot caller. I have to be the shot caller. And we were trying to kind of pawn it off a little bit. Santorin still does semi-shot calling and shot calling on the side, but I have to be the main voice, and there has to be one main voice that's going to make all the main decisions and has to be confident, and that has to be me.
제가 봤을 때는 굉장히 독특한 성격을 가지고 있는 것 같아요. 4차원 같은 그런 성향을 가지고 있고 승부욕이 대단하다. 지는 걸 싫어하고 그리고 승리하기 위해서 끊임없이 노력하는 일주일에 보여주는 연습량이 엄청납니다. 제2의 전성기를 맞이했다고 평가받는데
12시에 일어나서 그때부터 그냥 연습실 갔다가 4시쯤에 밥 먹고 좀 하다가 또 다시 가가지고 연습하고
We work from 10 AM to 10 PM, around 12 hours today.
Yeah, and then we can work for mid.
새벽 2시쯤에 다 들어가서 자는 시간이었지.
Nothing comes before our job to us. Literally nothing. Girlfriends, family, just job is first.
These are guys who play more hours than most people can comprehend.
좀 지면 약간 자기가 좀 싫은데 그래도 저는 지더라도 제가 좀 제 플레이가 잘 나왔다던가 하면 좀 그래도 잘 수 있는데 좀 안 자는 편이라서 그런 것 같아요.
They've been stuck in a grind. I mean, Bjergsen's been top performer for 2 years now, and it can get lonely.
Eventually, I'm not going to be satisfied with just winning an A. I'm gonna want more. If you want to win MSI, if you want to win Worlds, you have to work your hardest, and you have to work pretty much all day every day.
일단 LOL을 플레이하시는 분들한테 뭐 팁을 드리자면, 첫 번째는 그냥 자기 플레이에 대해서 좀 더 발전하고 싶다 하는 그런 생각을 가지고 플레이를 하면서 좀 두 번째는 게임 내적으로 돌아와서 좀 미니맵을 많이 보면서 게임 하면서 게임 내내 생각을 하면서 자기 플레이를 좀 생각하면서 하는 게 중요하다고 생각해서 세 번째는 그냥 게임을 좀 즐기면서 하는 게 중요한 것 같아요. 그래서 이 세 가지만 좀 지키면서 하면 저처럼 잘할 수 있을 것 같고
We're really trying to pick ourselves up because we had some pretty rough LCS weeks. We're currently 0-3 in the last three games that we played, and it's been a long time since it's been like that for us. We usually have been winning a lot, and even if we lose one or two games, we pick ourselves up very quickly. But now we just need like a boost, and that's why we're working extra hard to pick it back up.
It's not even an exciting statement. We made Worlds every single year. What's to stop us this year?
The crowd is ready. The teams are ready.
We really relied on, you know, Bjergsen to carry pretty much all of our matches because, you know, he's a really strong carry.
Let's just do this shit.
Our teamwork just wasn't there. So we've been working on, you know, overall team strategy and team synergy. That was something that we were really lacking. We've been practicing harder and harder, and it's something that it's finally coming together.
Elise is not there yet, she's there now. Can we go? Can we go? I'm on the side, ready to TP, ready to TP.
Everything that I put time and effort into would be for nothing if I don't go to Worlds.
Remember, Dyson, you don't want to dive in too deep, because I can't do damage. I cannot do damage if you do that.
I don't really think too much about, like, can we win Worlds? It's hard, because people improve, I improve, but you never really know how you stack up until you actually play against someone.
We wanted to go near Sarkhan. Gnar is squishy as fuck. He's building a split push. Go push up top, go push up top. I'm gonna push mid, you push up top. Okay, back, back. Keep coming back, turtle. Nice. I'm going!
He's really, really mature now, and he's really, really smart.
Bjergsen really thinks about the game, how he can improve, why he lost, what he can do to change. It's not his gift, it's what he does with it.
We want to make sure that they send three bot to catch. Because if they only send two, we die them. But if they send three, you catch top.
Is this because every time we caught bottom, they took vision control? And every time we took vision control, like, we can't really do anything.
We're no longer a win lane, win game kind of team. We win through rotations, we win through good vision control, we win through good strategy.
Make sure they can't fucking do bear. I'm gonna be really strong on the base.
I want to show that North America is not a pushover, that we're not the same region we were a year ago.
And the first pick of support. We should be.
They're just gonna take Thresh. We need to ban Gragas, dude. Gragas is way too relevant. Just here to get priority. This game I got priority, we just failed the bot dive. What happened in the bot dive? Shouldn't we be able to execute that?
Semi-final series to face Counter Logic Gaming as they take out Team Liquid.
It feels really good to beat Liquid because it means we're secure for Worlds, which is huge. Like, sure, we had a lot of different ways we could get to Worlds, but this was the easiest one, just straight up winning, and hopefully we beat CLG and we get the number one seed. I kind of lost the touch and shot calling during the regular season because I felt less and less important, and we didn't really have someone like Andy to help us with shot calling, help me what I should say, what we should do, and just these last couple of weeks, I've had a lot of help with that, and I feel like now I can do a lot for the team without making plays, without doing all these things. I can just be a solid shot caller and lead the team to victory.
So yeah, I'm just gonna go over opening ceremony and closing ceremony.
You can walk up pretty aggressively.
It was like we had bad picks and bad play. Right, well, I don't think we need to change our bends. What do you want to bend? Trist is like Ash would do the exact. Ash would stomp us harder last game.
Yeah, Ash would do it.
Ash would stomp us so much harder last game. We get mid priority and then we get vision, but like I don't know where we are, but I'm up all alone. That's why they just go on me.
We should talk as a team before everyone splits up.
We need to do fun stuff anyway, no?
Like, we weren't playing to win the last game. Like, the last game we went to, we've already given up. So that's like a mindset we have to change, because when we're playing a best of five, we never give up. And we've never been in a situation where we've been like one game to losing before, but you know, we gave up. And it really fucking sucks that we lost.
Oh! Ah! 제가 좋아하는 과목은 수학이나 네, 수학을 제일 좋아했던 것 같아요. 이득과 손해를 좀 예를 들어서 수학 같은 경우에는 명확하게 알 수 있기 때문에 그런 걸로 인해서 게임할 때 좀 계획적으로 할 수 있다던가 그런 게 있는 것 같아요. 일단 장애물이 가장 될 만한 거는 지금 아직 롤드컵까지 기간도 너무 많이 남았고요. 너무 좀 무섭기는 해요. 좀 어떻게 슬기롭게 풀어나가냐에 따라서 성적이 좀 어떻게 나오냐 많이 갈라질 것 같아요. 얼마나 유지하느냐, 꾸준히 연습하느냐, 네, 이게 가장 중요한 것 같아요. 다 이길 수만 있는 건 아니거든요, 모든 게임에.
이미 진짜 전설이 돼버린 선수라 뭔가 더 욕심낼 게 있을까 싶기는 해요. 사실 뭐가 있을까. 흔히 하는 말로 롤드컵 2회 우승이라면 정말 범접할 수 없는 업적이라고 저는 생각하고 있거든요.
Dragon comes up on 22. So there's
out 2 seconds?
No, 22 minutes. So we're not gonna
I think
that.
Bjergsen in a 1v1 scenario is probably the best player in the world. And I would rank Bjergsen above Faker in terms of being a better overall player. Because of how he has grown with his team, the fact that he's a shot caller, we know that, and also the fact he plays multiple play styles.
I don't think he'll carry us to Worlds. I think everyone will do their share. Bjergsen probably will do more than his fair share. No one talks about the players that only made it one fourth of the way. He still has a long journey in front of him, and I think he can do it.
페이커 선수가 세계 최고의 미드라이너라고 생각하고 있고요. 또 그에 맞게 저희 팀원 모두가 세계 최고의 팀원이라고 생각하고 있습니다. 이번 시즌을 만약에 우승을 하게 된다면 이제 롤드컵 최초 2연속 우승이 되고요.
I had my start where I was a rookie and now I'm in a space where I feel like I'm very comfortable with my team. I'm very confident. Wait, is this my chance at Worlds? Is this my only chance?
진짜 롤드컵 우승만을 위해서 지금 그냥 똑같이 연습에만 매진하고 있습니다. 지금처럼만 유지를 하고 더 남긴다면 진짜 최고의 선수 될 수 있지 않을까요?